Good morning, everybody. We are starting our sectoral session on agriculture, agriculture marketing, food processing, fisheries, horticulture, and ARD. I would request the chairman of today's session, Dr. Sanjeev Chopra, Additional Chief Secretary, Agriculture Department, Government of West Bengal. Sir, please come up on the stage. I would also request Sri B.P. Gopalika, Principal Secretary, Animal Resources Development Department, Government of West Bengal. He will be here any moment. I would request Dr. Ravi Inder Singh, Secretary, Fisheries Department, Government of West Bengal. Sir, please come up on the stage. I would request Sri Pradeep Kumar Majumdar, Advisor to the Honorable Chief Minister, Government of West Bengal. Sir, please take your seat. I would request Sri Rajesh Sinha, Secretary, Agricultural Marketing Department, Government of West Bengal. Sir, please come up on the stage. I would request Mr. B. Sumant, President, FMCG Business, ITC Limited. I would request Mr. Rajoshi Banerjee, Managing Director, Rasvan Seafoods. Mr. Sagar Duriani, Founder, Wow Momo, please come up on the stage. Mr. Alexis Bossiot, Trade and Investment Commissioner, Elenders Investment and Trade, Embassy of Belgium in India. Dr. Giordano, I think he is not here now. I would request Ms. Bhavna Bishwanath, Director, Crimco BV and Talsma Technique Limited, please come up on the stage. Now I would request the chairman of today's session, Dr. Sanjeev Chopra, to start the deliberations. Sir, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Madhupurna, and a very warm welcome to all of you. Because the session is only for 90 minutes, so we have to start on time, and you cannot have a discussion for 90 minutes, therefore we thought we'll intersperse it with some films, some chat shows and some panels to make it as lively and as interesting as we can make it. So without much ado, and as we go along, I'll introduce the panelists as they come along, because otherwise it becomes a bit too boring if I have to start, and then everyone will forget who the other person was. So let's start with the films. We have a film on agriculture, we have a film on animal husbandry and allied sectors, and then we'll go along. Yes. Lights out and action begins.
Thank you.
have another film after this. The second one is on animal resources department. Mr. Mitra, you're sitting on the wrong seat. You come to your chair. Oh, this Devashim is okay. You're right on this. Who's sitting there? Who's missing here? Okay. Somebody's missing here. Okay. Right. Okay. Yeah. Okay, our panel is almost complete. We have this film. Where's the second film? Yeah. Thank you. friends, this was, as you've seen, West Bengal, the land of plenty, and we're going to make it the land of plentiful with all the initiatives. And, you know, the fruit of the pudding is always in the eating, because all of us will keep saying that we do this and we do that. But just about a month ago, I think about 6 weeks ago, all of us, I mean, those of us in the government, were at a particular Chamber of Commerce where an issue had been raised about how difficult it is for people to do agribusiness in Bengal, because you have to go to many different points for a fertilizer license, for a pesticide license, for insecticide license. We had promised at that point that by the BGBS, we'll be able to have an application so that the entrepreneur, the agri-entrepreneur, does not have to go to many places but can do it at the click of the mouse. The mouse is also part of the animal husbandry regime. That's why we thought of the mouse and not the rock or not the stone or anything else. Remember, whatever happens, there has to be agriculture and nature there. So even if it is the mouse has to be remembered. So we have a very short opening of this new opportunity that we have. I'll request Jethet Roy and InGreens, who developed this, to launch the formal, to click. And see, this is part of the part of our Matir Katha app.
So thank you, sir. Respected dignitaries on the stage and the esteemed audience here. As sir said, we have brought to you the online licensing system for seeds, pesticide, and fertilizers. So I'll request my colleague here, Sayantan Pal, to click the mouse. And now you have the opportunity to apply for any of these licenses for seed, pesticide, or fertilizer sitting at your place. And the whole thing is automated. Your application processing, and every moment of interface, you will get a communication from our department that regarding the stage of your application. You have to visit only once, that is when the license is ready to receive the license, and maybe once for verification. Everything is streamlined, and with one window, you can apply for any sort of license.
I think this calls for a round of applause, so I mean, we can celebrate this, because the issue earlier was, let me explain how complicated it was, because if you want to set up a fertilizer facility in, say, 20 different blocks, then you have to apply in each block. If you wanted to sell pesticides in 20 blocks, you had to go to all those 20 blocks. And you had to prove, and I mean, of course, you needed a certification that you live in that block. Now, obviously, a person cannot live in 20 blocks, right? And therefore, a lot of little problems that were there, which were brought to our knowledge, and we tried to sort them out. Thank you, Jitin. Sir. And so what we're doing now is, you know, we will be having, we're having two panel discussions, and we have a very distinguished set of people here. The first panel discussion is called Partners in Progress. Farmers, FPOs, and business enterprises. Because let's understand that at the end of the day, unless the farmers and the organizations and enterprises work together, I mean, you could produce all the bananas in the world, but you need a Mayank Jalan to sort of market those bananas. So what we'll do is that in the first round, we'll have a discussion on partners in progress, farmers, FPOs, and business enterprises. And we have B. Sumant, Debashish Mitra, Amit, and Rajarshi Banerjee to talk to us about this. We've given these names, but in case they'd like to speak on some other other aspect, most welcome to do that. We have two panels. The second panel is on leadership, technologies, institutions, and international collaborations, in which we'll have Mayank Jalan, our legislator, Mawa Moitra, who's actually shown how business leadership can work very closely with political initiative and how we can transform economies. And we'll have Alexis, who's with us. We have Torn, and we've just been joined by Bhavna Vishwanath, who will also be speaking to us about how, and she had some wonderful ideas on how we can integrate these things. So let's start with Sumant, who's a leading agri-entrepreneur from ITC. You can speak from here, would that be better? I would suggest that you can reduce the glare of lights here, you know, it's too difficult. Because this is the discussion on agriculture, not the Filmfare Awards, so we could sort of, you know, very strong here.
Thank you, Sanjeev. Members of the dais and the audience, my name is Sumant. I look after the fast-moving consumer goods business of ITC Limited. Now, this is an investment summit, so I'll get down to business on investment in West Bengal. ITC, as you know, is a Calcutta-based company, and we've been here for over 100 years. But of late, the resurgence in Bengal has been tremendous. And just to prove that, we've actually been one of the leading investors in the state. We've set up 3 new factories over the last 2 years in Dhulagarh, Uluberia, and Panchla. And I'm happy to report that all 3 factories are up and running. We produce everything from atta. We have 3 biscuit lines. We have 2 noodle lines. We have a potato chip line. We've got 4 finger snack lines. So all of them are up and running. All of them are producing. There are more than 2,000 people employed. When we set up a business, we also look at the back end of the supply chain. So, you know, we've developed people for, we procure a lot of our rice meal, corn meal, and so on. The rice meal, the rice is grown in Bengal, it's milled here. All of our raw materials are processed locally. So, you know, there's a knock-on effect for the entire supply ecosystem of everybody who supplies into us. We also work with the agriculture sector to get the kind of raw materials we want. For example, for Ashirwad Atta, there are certain grades of wheat that we use. So we're working with Bengal farmers to look at growing the varieties that we want and also improving productivity. We believe we've got, we did about 2,000 acres of cultivation last year, and we were able to establish about 25% higher yields in the varieties that we were looking for. We hope to ramp up the acreage significantly going forward. And I think that will help the farmers to improve their realization. It also benefits us in terms of reducing the distance traveled by the raw material. As a company, we're pretty active. So we have these strong backward linkages. Forward linkages are also important. We invest significantly in our distribution chain. We service about 2 million retailers directly. And I think the potential of the distribution system to provide employment is also significant. So we, you know, employ a lot of salesmen, we have distributors, we support retailers, and I think that also fuels the ecosystem. So if you ask the question as an investor, why Bengal and why East? If I look at my sales today, East has been leading the other regions, North, South, West. As of today, we have 40% higher growth rate in the East than any other region, right? And this has been true for the last couple of years, and I see it being true for many more years going forward because all of the eastern states are revamping their economies, and I think there's huge potential. And both East and Northeast are growing significantly. So where would you locate your facilities? Now with GST, you can locate it anywhere. And I think why West Bengal? Because West Bengal is the gateway to the East. From a supply chain perspective, apart from the 3 factories we put in, we're also putting in an integrated logistics hub in West Bengal that will service the entire East and Northeast. Simply because you want to locate your facilities here because not only is the industrial climate good now, you have great backward linkages. This is one of the most progressive states when it comes to agriculture. So if you're in a food processing industry, from a raw material perspective, you can't find a better location, right? And with growing infrastructure,